I have touched on this theory on previous videos very briefly, but in here I will expand on it massively. By the end of Little Nightmares 2, the secret unveils to whom or what the Eye is, which had many paintings throughout the first game. It seems to be an entity that all the residents of Little Nightmares 2 are under the influence of. There are even mechanical eyes which act as a level of security in the Maw, and the nest to turn any escapee children into stone. But what's interesting is that the Eye wasn't the one building the mechanical eyes. The residents were the ones. The Eye is an entity that doesn't directly control the people, but manipulates them to do certain things. Or that's at least what it appears to be the case at the first glance. Hi folks, I'm R, your narrator. There will be spoilers in this video, so just keep that in mind. Today, I will try and answer what the Eye is, or what it symbolizes. Going through the digital concept art book, the creators had a very different idea of what the Eye or the tower would look like, but ended up changing it to what it is now. A meshy mass consisting of many large eyes. The Eye could symbolize the real eyes in the real world, how every action we take is overseen by some higher entities that we will never know of throughout our lives. Every action we take throughout the day is orchestrated by the higher eyes, who sit atop their chairs and manipulate us to carry out certain actions. We as people think we have free will and do as we wish, but if we open our eyes, we see that every thought we have in our heads, every word we speak, and every action we take is due to what we hear and see. And nowadays, the easiest way of manipulation is through media and screens. I can't be the only one who saw a post or a video on YouTube back in the day, then quickly became angry and built some strong opinions, to then realize it was all a baseless sham. Maybe the creators wanted to portray what media and screens could potentially do, and how dangerous they can be. They cover our minds with a thick brick wall, possess us, then make us do certain things mindlessly. Now that is a big metaphor, which I think the creators of Little Nightmares 2 wanted to show. But shifting the gears to a more literal point of view of the game, leaving all the wokeness behind, what is the Eye in the game? The Eye visually looks like a blob, with soft and squishy outer layer to die for. No wonder why Manu decided to stay with the Eye for the rest of his life. All jokes aside, this monster looks creepy as hell. But again, it looks really vulnerable. Imagine if an eyelash drops into one of the eyes. That's it, he's done for. Alright, sorry, I promise it was the last joke. The Eye seems to have some sort of physical abilities. Enlarge in size and engulf everything atop it. That is what happens at the end when Six's music box gets destroyed. The Eye enlarges in size, engulfing all the rooms. Now going over the magical side of the story, the Eye seems to be capable of bending time and space, and hence, the reality. It could also brainwash people and manipulate them to do certain things, without lifting a finger. But how could he, you might ask? He's just a goo, there are no fingers. And I'm calling it a he, as it rolls on my tongue better. I realize it could very well be a she or an it. We can assert this idea that the Eye is capable of bending time and space, as the entire tower seems distorted. And also the time loop exists where Manu sees his older self and battles him. The Thin Man. The Eye also easily brainwashes and manipulates the people, as we can see that pretty much with all the residents of the Pale City. All the viewers are totally gone in the cognition department, including the doctor and the teacher, as they all seemingly had some sort of access to TVs. Now this brings us to the final mentioned ability, bending reality. What we could ask ourselves is how is it possible for the residents of the Pale City to be easily manipulated, to live an actual nightmare from the outside perspective, while being fully okay with it. Why are they not taking any actions against it? Well, we don't know how the world looks to them through their own perspectives. They might live in a world that looks absolutely normal to them, or that is what the eye shows to them. We can read in an interview that the residents of the Pale City are blinded to the truth, that a monster is taking control over them. That is also what happens to Six when she's playing with her music box at the end. She is blinded to the truth that she is imprisoned in a creepy room, deformed in a shape of monster, and instead possibly sees that she's in a safe, perfect place with what she loves, her music box. When Mono also gives in and allows the eye to take control over him, his reality quickly changes, and he gets stuck in an isolated room to live the rest of his days in solitude, safe from any betrayal and heartbreaks. According to the aforementioned information, we can confirm that the eye is capable to distort the reality. Now that we know what the eye is capable of and what it symbolizes, let's answer the question to what it is. If we take the question literally, the eye is an almighty, omnipotent, and overseeing entity that no one can defeat, at least not physically. You cannot drop a nuke on the eye and destroy it. And let me tell you why. The eye is a mesh of destructive obsessions and ideas. You can destroy a person or many, but you can never destroy an idea. It lives on. That is exactly the same with the eye. The eye has manifested within the signal tower, a place far from the reach of everyone. A place that may or may not actually exist. This theory is gonna get a little complicated. So grab your anti-brainfuck smoothies, massage your heads a little, and let's get right into it. I theorize that the eye is the projection of our worst obsessions and thoughts. When Mono hits the music box, he gets transported into a dark, empty room, presumably within the signal tower. Then he suddenly gets back to where Six was, with the eye enlarging in size and things floating around. I believe the obsession of Six with her music box is visualized by a large eye monster, with crumbling walls and floating items. The presence of these obsessions and thoughts created the monster and gave him power. Towards the end, the tower is collapsing with the eye enlarging in size and engulfing everything around it. In other words, the eye is being hurt or even dying. But the eye becomes stable again when Mono is dropped to the depth, fueling the eye with the bad thoughts and ideas, thoughts of being lonely, betrayed, heartbroken, and defeated. That is why he gets placed in an isolated room where he can stay safe from any more betrayal. It's better to be lonely after all, than being betrayed and heartbroken over and over again. The eye bends the reality for Mono and places him in a room which turns him into a glitch. A mindless puppet that the eye can directly use for blinding other resilient characters to be blinded by their own obsessions and thoughts. For the sake of this theory, we can assume the signal tower is the eye and the eye is the signal tower. It's the domain of the eye and things don't really make sense to us there. How things make sense to us in the real world. But then again, through the perspective of possessed individuals, everything seems normal even within the signal tower. As mentioned by Mervik, the senior narrative designer of the game, the world of Little Nightmares came to be as the residents of Little Nightmares ignored the very same question for thousands of years. They also are blinded by their obsessions, being happy for a brief moment with what they like, ignoring the real problems surrounding them. The eye is the manifestation of problems accumulated on each other for thousands of years from thousands of different people. People having bad thoughts and ideas, or actual problems being ignored to the point that a monster is created who takes over the residents. The people are possessed by their obsessions. They could be their TVs, their students, their patients, their music boxes, hunger and greed, and a lot more. The point is, the residents of the Pale City and the Ma ignore the Eye Monster, which is the manifestation of their problems and bad thoughts, as they're possessed by their obsessions. For example, the Eye could be fueled by suicidal tendencies, or even killing tendencies, which is what the Hunter desires. It could be fueled by medical malpractice and unethical experimentation, which the Doctor possibly practiced during his career. It could be cruel punishment techniques of the teacher, which terrified the students and scarred them for life. Or it could be feelings of loneliness and actions of betrayal. When the people ignore these actions and bad thoughts, without reflecting on whether what they did was good or bad, trying to sedate the thoughts by destructive habits such as watching TV or eating, or as mentioned by the creators, escapism, all of those culminate to become an actual monster. Hence we get the Eye Monster. The Eye is the result of the people's misbehaviors and wrongdoings. They also never try to fix it and ignore it for thousands of years until it takes over their lives. The Eye Monster didn't land down from the sky or another planet. It is not alien. It is something way too familiar and extremely close to us. It's the projection of our unresolved wrongdoings and bad thoughts, which builds up over time if ignored. Wow, that was deep as the pit Mono dropped into. Well folks, this brings us to the end of the video. Hope you enjoyed it and it didn't remind you of how scary the world is. For more videos, stay tuned right here by hitting the subscribe button and the notification bell. If you want to contact me directly, you can do so by hitting me up on Twitter with the same name. It's been your host R, thanks for watching the video, till the next time. Have a fantastic day.